want us to piss our pants, don't you?
What?
You just want us to piss our pants, don't you?
Yesterday, I thought, actually, for the first time, one was really getting it. It was like about 11, 12 footers. Now, when you're looking at the gators, just so you know, when you're looking at the head of the gator, when you see the nose to the eye, the inches on that is comparable to the feet on their body. So about this gator that was laying, the bigger one, that was probably about a 7-foot gator just by looking at its head. From every inch from the nose to the tip of the eye, that's equivalent to that on their body.
Thank you.
so the cows just get like pretty much like free range. But this is truly the best cattle pasture you can have, because during the wintertime, I mean, not only is there unlimited grass, but during the wintertime, once the water, because it fluctuates, it goes up and down, once it covers that green grass, it won't freeze it if we have a hard freeze, and they'll say, you know, we don't have to bale hay for our cows during the winter. So it makes it really nice. So we're the top second cattle state in America.
Really?
Most people don't know that either, yeah. Yeah, but, you know, Texas is first. But we've got, you know, the second largest cattle ranch in America is right down the road from here. So we're a huge cow state. We mainly do, like, beef cows. And the cows up here, though, they lose about 10% of the gators. Yeah, the gators eat everything. I've lost 5 good dogs in the past 6 years from hog hunting with the dogs. I've seen them take down hogs themselves. I've seen them take down turkey, deer. I've seen them eat everything, birds, you know, whatever. And they're cannibals, so they eat each other as well.
My word.
This was what I was trying to show you. This was like a former nest was in here. So they had, there's about 2-year-old gators. There's a bunch of them in here. But they, you know, they kind of stay right here. Because this is, when it dries up, this will be really shallow. So this will all be grass. Pretty much everything you see will be green and grass, except this main channel out here. So we're still kind of in a wet season. But they'll get, the little gators feel safe in here because it's like a shallow pocket, and the big gators maybe won't come hunt as many of them, you know.
Great.
And this is probably one of the windiest things I've ever. It is bad. I'm going to still on the ride up to the beginning.
Thank you.
horses that we would use, and they're not wild.
Look at them, they're like statues.
Yeah, they just stand in there. That one, I think, is got some long back. Preservant and pickled everything, and they could take very accurate DNA samples, and they were and they were of English descent as well. So this is a really cool finding, but this is kind of, all this stuff kind of links with it, you know, because this is kind of that area.
How'd he get out here?
Well, from that where I was saying where they do the cows.
From the dry land.
Yeah, he came in. You can't always do this. And he's actually a good arrowhead hunter. I was standing out here with one of my groups one time, and we were all standing around. We were talking, and these guys were up in the muckboards, and they were big arrowhead hunters. They dug big ones all the time. And we were, right when I left, he started rushing the program. Seen 100 of them. shrimp that they eat. That boat's from South America, and it migrates here, and it has like a spoon shape, so it's really cooler. And in a couple hours, when it starts to, you know, climb over, I guess, the roof thing, the whole place will be like pink in here. There'll be thousands in here. Now you can see on the trees as well, you can see the water lines in here. There's like two sharp marks. That bottom one, that's this past summer, that's about how high it was in here. And it just kind of, so you couldn't walk obviously in here or whatever. But then there's a top sharp one at the top. And that was 2008, we had Tropical Storm Fay. And it went bone dry out here, it rose 10 feet in just a matter of a few days. Yeah, it was crazy. I live a few miles in the woods that way. It was about 3 foot of water in my front yard for 2 months.
Oh, it was crazy. God. Yeah. Did you have to take a boat to the car?
Yeah, pretty much. It was really bad. But, you know, Florida's just so flat, so once we get that rain, it goes for miles. We don't have any. Yeah, it's pretty bald in here right now. Yeah, the cows are coming here. Right here is a pretty natural crossing. This is, I've seen a lot of animals feeding right here. Like
cow pie.
Stuff. The gators. Yeah, there you go.
He's familiar with that.
Somebody stepped on him, too.
Yeah.
The bone too.
Is it you?
You're familiar with cattle?
Dairy cows, yeah.
Oh, cool. You raise them?
No. I grew up, my grandparents had a dairy farm.
Yeah.
an 8-year-old, you know, and that's, see, that was a vacation with his mom.
Right. And you had grandma on it.
Yeah. And grandma, you know, she was, you didn't have any assigned chores to grandma. You could do whatever you wanted.
Right.
But we did, you know, in the summer we'd go out, you know, and they would cut hay and, you know, load hay. We'd go out and do that, you know.
Right. All the farm chores.
Yeah.
I raised cattle. I raised Brangus, though. Myself.
And yeah, then gradually we had, I think they milked 32 head of Holstein, and they had 64 head of Black Angus.
Oh, okay.
So raised some beef.
Right.
Because he didn't make a whole lot of money on milk.
Right, that's what I was thinking. It'd be better to just.
You said these are snipers?
These are, yes. Now the water, it's so dark color, it's actually like really clean, like a white sand bottom, but the cypress trees have that tannic acid in the needles, and it stains the water with tea color. So I really wish we had a sea through it. And sometimes it's easier, like we come out and we dig, you know, the garfish and stuff.
When there's more water flow?
Yeah, there's a little bit more
flow in it.
We're not too far.
We're
probably about a mile
or two. Haven't you noticed we've been going in circles?
Oh, no. Well, I saw my bearings when I landed.
Yeah, it's weird because, like, when the river comes up, there's, like, so much more water, but then you're stuck to the... There was one when we turned around. It's just so windy, it's like, and I think that we can't stop eating. There's been plenty of people out here who have done it. Like, if you don't know how to drive one of these, you just might as well not.
So I'm assuming if we're not seeing the alligators on the
bank,
right. They're all in the water.
Oh, yeah. We're riding over, I mean, thousands. There are so many in here. If you fell in, you know. I mean, we do swim out here every weekend during the summer, but we kind of have our better spot. We get in groups. We have rope swings out here, yeah. During this weekend, there'll be hundreds of boats, locals out here, and everybody cooks out in camps, swims, all that.
And what was that, like, pavilion? Was it?
That was, we have those. They're kind of like storm shelters. Just to get out of the rain and stuff.
I noticed that one back there had a barbecue grill,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, we improvise them, so you can meet up and do stuff out there.
Yeah, people come out here,
yep.
You know, and have a picnic.
Yeah.
Or boating or fishing or...
Exactly, camping, all that. Yeah, every weekend, it's like the local, it's the town of Christmas. You both usually nice food in your house, so everybody's got an airboat. Here you go, an airboat. That's really cool from the bottom. Like when we go, and my husband has got this is a 502, he's got a 540. His boat's always been out to sea water for miles, like 10 miles we can go back in the river. But it's crazy. They're really cool. Can we grab a picture of this?
We're not taking you out this weekend to go swimming.
Oh, no, she lives in a community with a pool, so that happens.
Crazy, it's really warm enough, too. It's almost sunny again.
Thank you.
distracted by him.
Really paid attention to
it. You may not see that.
Could be a different kind of cypress possibly too.
They're all along on the way to the pool.
Yeah, you're right. They're in and around those trees that are around, along the holding pond.
Yep.
I see in here it's nice and quiet.
Yeah.
Guess we're going for lunch or dinner.
Oh, what are you guys going to do?
Aunt Catfish.
Where?
Aunt Catfish up in Port Orange.
Yeah, we were in it when we turned.
When you were on Cupid.
Yeah, on Cupid.
You were
in
there.
Oh, okay.
Yep, there's, and we've got a post office that people travel all over the world to mail their cards because they get stamped from Christmas Portal. We've got a really cool park, too. It's free to go in. It's Fort Christmas Park. They've got all the old, the fort, the battlefield and stuff, and all the old cracker houses they take from all over, and they set them up, and they all... They all look like authentic, like you can walk through them and they're all kept in really good shape.